Okay, so today we have Oingo Boingo, which might be my favorite band name I've ever heard, and Dead Man's Party. So this band has been requested multiple times, and searching them up, I didn't know anything about them, but seeing Danny Elfman and seeing all the work that he has done, as a composer in movies and everything, it's very cool to see. So I am familiar with his work, even if I didn't know. But I've never listened to Oingo Boingo, so here we go. I just love that name. Like I said, Dead Man's Party. This is the one that many people requested. So anyway, let's get to it. I'll shut up and let's go. It's a long version as well.
Good.
God. So Dead Man's Party, Oingo Boingo. I have to say, I don't think I was ready for this. My goodness gracious. You know, it's like that thing, you know, there's so much going on where it's like I didn't know where to listen to, you know, I didn't know where to put my ears. You know, with the horns, the, you know, the, obviously the horn section there, the, to make it even more kind of, more elegant, I guess, in a way, make it even more bold. Obviously as well, the great bass line in there, the, you know, great guitar riffs, you know, just, you know, very upbeat as well, guitar riffs. And, obviously here, my first time listening to, Danny Elfman on, you know, singing for this band or whatever, you know, his voice, his range obviously was, you know, is just superb. You know, he, the way he could go, you know, so high and come back down. And I mean, yeah, his range was all over the place and he was just, you know, really showing off his chops here. And again, like I say, you know, and also the, there's a keytar in there. Obviously there's keyboards too, but there's that keytar in there, like a synthesizer thing where that, when you, you know, when that came in, I was surprised. I was like, Jesus, that's another instrument on top of everything. But again, I it's good. I really enjoyed how many instruments there were, how just, how, you know, how loaded the song was of just instruments. And just, Danny's just, you know, singing all over the place. And he sounds like he's jumping around when he's singing and everything. It's so upbeat. And it's so upbeat, but the song is obviously kind of dark, which I really enjoyed. I love, you know, I love their take on this subject. So, and I mean, again, with a band called Oingo Boingo, you know, if they're going to talk about, you know, do a dark song, I figure it's probably going to sound kind of, you know, light. It's going to sound a little bit upbeat, and that's what you got here. so I was just, I mean, throughout the whole song, you know, I was kind of just laughing to myself at some parts again, you know, because it's my first time listening to this band. And again, they sounded so happy and they sounded so charming, and you know, that just kind of made me laugh. It kind of made me smile. Obviously, it's just, you know, it's a nice feeling. I mean, I got from this band. And also, I wanted to talk about hold the phone. Wanted to bring up the personnel here, but first of all, just to talk about Danny's voice again. You know, it always happens to me when I first hear somebody's voice, and you know, I might think of somebody who comes to mind that I think he kind of sounds like in here. I mean, I think about especially when he was saying, you know, it's only me, he's going on. I got some, you know, Robert Smith vibes from him, I have to say. You know, and again, this was 1985, you know, The Cure was big here, I mean, too. But yeah, Robert Smith came to mind. Also, you know, right off the bat, what came to mind was Weird Al Yankovic for some reason. I don't know, you know, just Elfman's delivery just reminded me of Weird Al for a second. And I don't know, I just had to also put that out there if that makes any sense. But yeah, Weird Al and Robert Smith came to mind. But obviously, you know, Danny, you know, he has his own unique voice here. He put his own stamp on the song, obviously. And yeah, but you know, just a little bit of taste of Smith and Weird Al at some point as well, I guess. Anyway, so looking at the personnel here, there's a lot going on. Obviously, like I said, there's so many instruments in there, you know, but so many instruments, but they all obviously work very well together. You know, it's just, it was a great, like I said, great sections all over the place. So Danny Elfman on lead vocals and the rhythm guitar, Steve Bartek on lead guitar, and also I apologize if I butcher some of these names, but anyway, John Avila, I want to say, on bass, keytar, and vocals. So there's the keytar he was doing. My goodness. Mike Bacic, I want to say, on keyboards. Johnny Hernandez on drums and percussion. Sam Phipps, I guess, my goodness, on tenor saxophone. Leon Schneiderman on baritone and alto saxophone. So there's three different saxophones in here. My goodness. Dale Turner on trumpet and trombone. And then Michael Frondelli on mixing. So like I said, there's, what, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 guys right there, including the mixer. And, I mean, you could hear that. You could hear that there's multiple people on this just going to town on such a dark kind of song. But at the same time, like I said, they're making it sound so gleeful. And I just really appreciate that. I really appreciate what they were trying to do here. Anyway, so like I was talking about with the song, obviously, you know, the first lyrics, you know, going to lyrics now, moving on. If I could scroll up, hold the phone on genius.com here. So I'm all dressed up and with nowhere to go. I mean, sorry, my life. Walking with a dead man over my shoulder. It's like, well, Jesus Christ. I'm all dressed up and nowhere to go, walking with a dead man over my shoulder. And obviously, you know, as, you know, searching up stuff here, talks about how this song, you know, I see on Song Facts, and I mean, you can see it for yourself, obviously, the song is about attending a funeral and being buried. It's just like, what a great, you know, being buried, that's very nice. You know, it goes on, you know, the lyrics make a few references to it, you know, with the opening line, all dressed up and nowhere to go, walking with a dead man over my shoulder. That's pretty telling. It also says, you know, Danny would go on to sing, you know, got my best tie, got my best suit and my tie, shiny silver dollars on either eye. I hear the chauffeur coming to the door, says there's room for maybe just one more. It goes on, you obviously, you know, being dressed, you know, being in your best suit, you know, usually you're buried in your best suit, your best clothes and all this stuff. And it's, you know, that's kind of the tradition or whatever. You're buried with, you know, your best clothes on and, you know, your best, you know, try to look your best even when you're dead. And, you know, again, it's such a, you know, a dark topic to cover, but they did such a great job here, you know, talking about these things. You know, waiting for an invitation to arrive, going to a party where no one's still alive. And again, it's just the way he delivers this, these lyrics is just like, it's so fun. Even if everybody's dead, and it goes on, you know, that's repeated one more time there, going to the chorus. And again, he just belts out this chorus. It just sounds so nice. And it's just, like I said, it's just so bold and, catchy. So such a catchy song, obviously too. I was struck by lightning walking down the street. I was hit by something last night in my sleep. It's a dead. So this part, you know, I am a little bit, you know, confused in a way, because it talks about, you know, I see some things talking about how this is a dead man going to his own funeral, and he's talking, you know, or it's just, you know, somebody, you know, going to a funeral or whatever, and talking about being buried, but not actually being buried, but it's, you know, so there's just a little bit of differences I see here on, you know, some pages talking about what the song is about. But anyway, you know, because it goes on here, it seems like this is what the person, you know, what you died of, what the person died of, you know, struck by lightning, walking down the street, hit by something last night in my sleep. It's a dead man's party. Who could ask for more? it's just, that made me laugh too during the song, because it's just like, it's a dead man's party, you know. What else would you want? Everybody's coming. Leave your body at the door. Leave your body and soul at the door. And again, this could be sung in such a dark, cryptic way. But Danny does not do that. You know, I can imagine there might be, you know, covers done of the song or whatever. People might have taken it a different way and done it kind of, you know, more morbidly or, you know, whatever. But, you know, here, obviously, Danny is just so happy. And like I said, I can't say it enough. You go into the post-chorus, don't run away. It's only me. Only me going on. You know, again, don't be scared. It's just me. Again, yeah, the third verse you're talking about. Again, I'm all dressed up with nowhere to go, waiting for an invitation to arrive. I got my best suit and my tie. Goes on and on again with some repetition. Maybe there's room for one more. And I do want to say, because this comes up, you know, multiple times in the song. Anyway, thought a burp was coming on, but I wanted to talk about with this little story here going on. My goodness, it talks about, you know, the reference to the bus conductor, a short story by E.F. Benson about a hearse driver, first published in 1906. And it goes on, the story has been adapted several times and spawned an urban legend, with each version using the catchphrase "room for one more." And again, it's one of those, you know, little campfire kind of stories, you know, you tell around the campfire and get scared and then you can't fall asleep at night or whatever. But yeah, and again, but how Danny says this and talks about this kind of story, but he's so happy at the same time. I can't get over it, and I've said it so much now, but he's just so cool. He's cool about all this, and he makes you feel nice to be dead. If you know, he makes it feel nice, you know, it makes you feel like okay, that you're dead and that you're attending your own funeral, or that you know, he makes it feel nice about attending funerals. You know, it's just like, it doesn't have to be a sad, depressing thing. But yeah, it's a good take on, it's a fun take. I mean, I have to say, it's a different take on, you know, funerals and attending your own funeral and, you know, what it's like, you know, dressing up in your best and dying and all this stuff. It's a very different take, and it's a very fun take, like I said, to do. And it's unlike anything I've heard before. There's so many different instruments going on here. Like I said, the horn sections were, you know, great. You know, I love the fantastic bass line, the uplifting guitar riffs, you know, everything was just beautiful. The keytar in there, didn't expect that to come in. But everyone on the song did their job, and they were just a boatload of fun. And like I said, I searching up Danny Elfman here, you know, it does say here in Song Facts, you know, talks about how he's a well-known composer for many Tim Burton movies, including The Nightmare Before Christmas, on which he also sang. He was the singing voice of Jack Skellington, my God. He also, you know, did stuff for Batman. He did the theme song for The Simpsons and many, many others. And also, I think he also worked on Wednesday, you know, how Tim Burton, you know, helped with Wednesday, the Netflix series too. So, I mean, yeah, it's just like his work's all over the place, and I didn't even know about the man until now. So anyway, what a great track. I love the approach to this. I'm glad these guys were requested. And again, Oingo Boingo. What a fun name. I mean, my God. Anyway, I guess that's all I got to say. So thanks for watching. Thanks for liking, subscribing, commenting. It's very hot in here, but we got through it. My goodness gracious. I feel like I'm sweating. But anyway, I'll talk to you guys again soon. Enjoy your day, night, whatever it is for you. And I'll see you guys on the flip side.